Today it's about optimizing a rod antenna. It's a really beautiful principle that has similarities with evolution in nature. Looking around in nature, you don't actually find many straight structures. Considering this, you might reflect that rod antennas too do not always have to be straight. I can imagine that Landstorfer, the pioneer of these developments, had this vision when inventing that kind of antennas. But how do you come up with something like that? Today I would like to explain how the principle works, and later we will set up the antenna and test it. You can find articles and books about it, which I have linked below. Just by the way, we made videos about antenna tools explaining radiation diagrams, reflection loss and the difference between dB, dBi and dBd. Today we are talking about dipoles that have a length of 1.5 lambda. I used the NEC program to calculate the radiation properties of the antenna with straight rods. The current distribution is more complicated than with the half-wave dipole. In addition to the maximum at the feed point, it has two further maxima on the rods. In principle, this arrangement can be considered as three coupled half-wave dipoles having a well-defined phase relation to each other. This gives us a radiation pattern like the one of a phased array. We get several main lobes with a directivity of 3.6 dBi maximum. Could we combine them into one main radiation lobe? You could actually do this by cutting the antenna into three half-wave dipoles and feed them using phase shifters. There is a certain phase relation where we get one rotationally symmetric main lobe with higher gain because the electromagnetic fields of the individual dipole elements are adding up in that direction. But there is another way to influence the phase relation of the electromagnetic fields, namely through the spatial form. Let's try that and arrange the two rods in a V shape. As a result of this, the field's phase relations are changing depending on the direction. An initial test is showing us that the directivity becomes stronger to the right and weaker to the left. Now we are wondering at what pitch angle you would get the maximum directivity. I found a nice way to compute that in the program CocoaNEC. And you know I used the program several times on the channel to analyze the radiation properties of my loop antennas. The user interface contains elements of programming language, which is a great feature enabling us to carry out iterative calculations. We are repeating calculations and we are changing parameters during this iteration process according to our self-defined criteria. That's cool, isn't it? In the program package, there was even a small example that I used as a basis for this investigation. This is my code for CocoaNEC, which I used to carry out my computations. I must admit that I'm using a very simple optimization algorithm here. For more complicated tasks, I would recommend a more powerful algorithm in order to save computation time. The program is varying the angle until the directivity of the antenna is reaching its maximum. And this is the result we get after some iterations. The V-shape is increasing the directivity to 6 dBi and we found the optimal pitch at 54.3 degrees. Now we will observe the optimization process a second time together with the three-dimensional radiation characteristics. Is this really the optimum or can we find something better? We now take up Landstorfer's idea, creating the antenna from several segments, varying all segments' pitch angles and length. This gives us a lot more degrees of freedom compared to our optimization of straight rods. The angles of the structure are not limited, the antenna could theoretically take any arbitrary shape. Then I let the computer do its thing again. Having now 5 degrees of freedom, it is taking a lot more computation time compared to the previous case with only 2 variable parameters. The computation time is growing exponentially according to the number of degrees of freedom. We can watch the shape of the antenna change as the optimization algorithm is progressing. After a number of iterations, the computer finds the known shape, generating the maximum directivity. Then let's take a look at the radiation characteristics. I have to show you this in time-lapse, because otherwise the process would take far too long for the video. Let me summarize that briefly. We started with the straight 1.5 lambda antenna having a maximum directivity of 3.6 dBi. And then we were computing the optimum angle for a V antenna. Its maximum directivity is 6 dBi at a pitch of 54.3 degrees, which corresponds to an angle of 108.6 degrees between the rods or wires. Applying Landstorfer's method, we were able to increase the directivity of the antenna up to 7 dBi. It doesn't matter what starting values you have chosen, the result will be always this funny shape that no one knew before. It's absolutely fascinating. Numerical mathematics is offering clever and powerful optimization algorithms, some of which actually use the strategies of evolution. This is a graphical representation that I created a while ago. A minimum of the function B is sought instead of a maximum, and x1 and x2 are the variables. The illustration shows how a simple algorithm works to find an extreme value. Each step in that landscape is representing a computation to analyze the properties of your subject. Advanced algorithms are trying to reduce the number of computations using a functional approximation of the landscape. However, in case this landscape is having lots of extrema, these algorithms tend to get stuck. In such a case, an evolutionary strategy could be applied, which is trying different approaches and a kind of marrying successful results. Everything that can be simulated by a computer can be optimized using these methods. By the way, Landstorfer applied this method successfully to Yagi and logarithmic periodic antennas as well. In general, optimization is an interesting field that is becoming increasingly important while stronger computers are constantly pushing it forward. The coming videos will be exciting too, because we want to set up the antenna and measure it. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.